Now that we've customized the login logic, we can also customize the logout logic. The way that we're set up now is if we come up to this icon up here and then we go down and click logout, this will take us back to the admin login page, which is completely fine. However, let's say you wanted to customize this logic so that you don't go back to this page, but for instance, you want to go back to the main landing page. There's a way that we could customize this whole functionality to be able to do that. And Voyager really does help us out. If we go over to the Voyager documentation and we head over to the overriding files, you can see here that not only can we change controllers, we can also change the views that are being served from the Voyager installation. All you would have to do is create a new folder in the resources views folder, create a new folder called vendor, new folder called Voyager, and then whatever it is that you're trying to customize. So let's head into the text editor. And because that vendor file is in vendor, let's head down to TCG, resources, views. It's actually going to be in dashboard and navbar.blade.php. And if you take a look here, you can see that this is where our Voyager logout is coming in. So we can go ahead and copy this file. And then we'll head up to our own app. Remember, because we don't want to change anything in the vendor folder. And we go to resources, views, and create a new folder called vendor, new one called Voyager. And then that folder that we're grabbing it from is dashboard. So let's take a look here. We go ahead and click on that dashboard. Let me open this up. And let's say we paste that navbar.blade.php in here. Okay, let's close up the old one so we don't get confused. Okay, let's slide that over a bit. And just to test this out, we're going to highlight all this. We're going to cut it out and we're going to say hi. Okay, so let's go back to the browser. Let's log in. admin@admin.com, password. And if you take a look, now our whole page is all messed up, but you can see right up here, the hi, H-I. I know it might be small, but it's right there. So let's go ahead and put this back and make sure that that's showing up okay. Okay, great, now it's back. So now that we have full control over this navbar, what we have to change now is this route. Okay, because right now this route is pointing to admin logout and we need it to point to our admin logout. In order to change that route, Voyager offers us another option. So if you go to the documentation and go to overriding routes, within the group of routes that it's given us, we can overwrite any of the routes that we need to here, okay, and point them wherever we want to. So let's go ahead and see if we can get that working. Let's go back to the text editor. And we'll go to web.php. These are where our Voyager routes are. And if we were to go and look at the list of routes that we have, we can do PHP artisan route list. And if we scroll up to the Voyager.logout, it's being pointed to in our navbar blade. You'll see that here. Okay, the route is Voyager logout. That's right here. Okay, so what's happening is that's the name of this route here, Voyager logout. So all we need to do is just change the controller that's being used to log out. And we already have a controller for that. If we head down to the vendor folder and go to Laravel, Fortify, Source, Controllers, Authenticated Controller. This is the controller that we can use to now, we can now point to this logout in this controller instead of the Voyager one. So how we would do that is go back to the web.php. We can now under this route, the Voyager routes, we can type route host. Okay, and it's going to be logout. And this is going to be Authenticated Session Controller class, and I think it's destroy right there. Destroy. Bring this up. And now we can rename this logout. Now what's going to happen is the route will now be admin logout instead of Voyager logout. Okay, so let's head back to the blade file. And in here, instead of Voyager logout, we can now put admin logout. And then the form action is going to logout. There's one more thing that we need to do. If we head up to the config folder and the Voyager config file, if you come down to the dashboard config dashboard, you'll see we have the Voyager generic.logout. So in here now we can just put admin.logout because that's the name of the route. So now let's go back to the browser and try to see if we can get this working. So refresh. Okay, let's try to open that up. And now let's click logout and see if it brings us back to that Laravel page. Okay, great. So now we're back at the just basic Laravel page. So now we've learned how to override files, and we've also learned how to override routes. So anything that you need to override, just take a look at the documentation and you should be able to. But now we have some examples to work with. I'm going to leave it there for now. I'm going to make sure to push all this code up to GitHub, and I'll leave all the links for everything that you guys need down in the description. In the next episode, we will be just putting some finishing touches on this project, and we'll be able to finish it up. So thank you for watching. I will see you guys next time.